Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome into our service tonight. We know it's been kind of a rainy day, but it's a good night to be inside and getting our mind on the Lord, away from everything that we've gone through today. So it's just a good time to have church, and that's what we're here for, is to represent the Lord and do our best to encourage you to want to know Him better. And we have some good singing coming up, and so be sure and stay with us. And we want to welcome all of you, especially the ones that are kind of homebound or not able to get out much anymore. And there's hospitals, nursing homes, and jails, and prisons, and so forth. We want you to know, we want to remind you that the Lord loves you just like He does all of us. Everybody's in a different place, a different position, but He loves us all alike. And you know, sometimes you might think that's a little strange. You might think, well, He has to love me better than He does so-and-so. Well, that's not true, but He loves us all alike, and He's not willing that any should perish. And so that is why we come each night, try to encourage you to seek the Lord while you can. We have a lot of folk that tune in. This is their church, they say. And we have a friend up at Moorhead, Brother Fred White, and he just this year he has lost his wife and son. And but he was just telling us recently about how much that he appreciates being able to sit in his home and hear good music and hear the word of the Lord lifted up, and it brings peace to him. And so we know this is just one of many that call this their church. Really, they're not able to go much anymore. So we want to say a special welcome to those. And so we want you to join in with us now. We have a short scripture, but it's a real good one. Lamentations, the third chapter, and starting with the 22nd verse. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because His compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore will I hope in Him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for Him, to the soul that seeketh Him. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. Lamentations 3:22 through 26, and that is a very long chapter, and I hope you get able to read it for yourself. But we are here because of the Lord's compassion, and so we're going to thank Him for that tonight. And His mercies are new every day, and aren't we glad? So let's just praise Him. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank You because You do love us. You don't forget us on some days and then bless us extra on others, but Lord, You love us at all times, and we thank You for that. And so as we go into this service, we ask for the Holy Spirit to speak and warm the hearts of those that are discouraged, that are stressing right now. Some of them just recently lost loved ones, and things like this. Lord, we need You in a special way. Thank You for Your mercies. Bless all of our guests, our phone operators, our staff, and the audience. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, tonight we're so happy to have these traveling people. They travel all over the country, but we got them to come this way tonight, Ronald and Margie Johns from Lexington, and they brought some people with them, but these folk have been on the road all summer here and there, and so we're glad they remembered us up here on the hill. So let's go over now for the music.
Well, praise the Lord. It's just an honor to be here tonight. And Sister Margaret, we just appreciate you and the good folks here at WLJC. And just knowing tonight that is you that are listening in. And I was thinking as you read that scripture that his mercies are renewed day by day. When I think of the goodness of the Lord, and I begin to think about over the last little while as we've traveled and the Lord has just been good to us. But I was thinking of, we went to a church not too long ago, and there were some folks that we met there, and they were talking about WLJC, and they were talking about their families that couldn't get out to the house of the Lord, but how that every evening that they would turn in, and this would become their, this is their church, and I praise the Lord for that tonight. And I want you to know tonight, you that are listening in, that I believe from the depths of our heart tonight, that whatever condition you're at, wherever you're at tonight, that the Lord can come exactly where you're at. And we were talking earlier before that the service started, and I believe that the Lord is soon to come. And I don't know what all is going to wait me over yonder. I know that the Bible said, eye hath not seen, and ear hath not heard, and neither has it entered into the heart of man the things that he's got in store. But yet I also begin to think of how that John the Revelator, he began to give us just a little vision of what awaits us over yonder. But there's a song tonight that we like to sing, and it just sort of speaks of where we're at tonight. It says, there's a country where no twilight shadows deepen. Well, an ending day where night will never be. Of a city where no storm clouds ever gather. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What will it we get over yonder and join the throne upon that glassy sheet, to join our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven
about this.
Well, a place where there is no misunderstanding, and from all enmity and strife that we are free. No unkind words within the heart is spoken. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get over yonder and join the throne upon that blessed seat, to join our to me.
about this tonight.
Well, when at last I'll see the face of Jesus, before whose image other loves all flee. But when they crown him Lord of Lords, I'm gonna be there. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get over yonder?
Whenever that we think about what awaits us over yonder, but let us also think about this tonight, that if you're at a place and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, there's folks that are standing by tonight, and you could call that number on the screen, and there's folks that would pray with you tonight, and we're going to be praying with you also. And you understand that no matter where you're at in life, and I'm one of those that I often tell folks, Sister Margaret, I don't care where you've been. I don't care where you've been at today. I know where that you can end up at tonight. You can end up in the arms of an almighty God, that you can come to him and you can surrender your life over to him. And I just love when we got a God like this, that he said, let whosoever would, to let them come and drink of the water of life freely. So I'm telling you tonight, there's hope in Jesus tonight. We're just honored. To say we're greatly honored tonight that our pastors are with us tonight. Brother Roy Stapleton, Sister Kathy Stapleton, and Brother Timmy sitting back here on this bass guitar. And I'm just telling you, we just thank the Lord that they just came and with us tonight. And they're going to get in and they're going to sing tonight. And we want you tonight, you make that phone call tonight. If you've got a need, you've got a request, I'm telling you tonight that God still answers prayers. I'm telling you tonight that no matter where the weakness of your life, there's strength in knowing the Lord tonight. You just come to the Lord tonight. You surrender it over to him. And I'm telling you what God can do tonight. I'm going to ask Brother Roy if he would right now just come obey the Lord tonight.
When I look around and see the good thing he does, I've got so much to tell.
Thank the Lord for saving me. I was lost to sin just like a lot of other people, but I thank God that he reached down one night and he brought me out of that miry clay. Saved me, set me up on a solid foundation. I praise him tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, this song here, it tells that we can't even walk without God holding our hand. You know, Margaret, I couldn't do anything without him holding my hand. When I was in sin, I don't know how I made it. But I know how I made it now because I've got Jesus with me. Hallelujah. Well, I thought number one would surely be me. I thought I could be what I want.
Hold it. For I learned to stand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
Hallelujah. Truly tonight, if we know how frail that we are, but how strong that He is. And knowing tonight that the Bible said when we are weak that He is strong. And I'm telling you tonight too, through all of your weaknesses, through all of your heartaches, and through all of your sorrows, the Bible said there's a friend that sticks closer than a brother.
Hallelujah, yes.
I just got to tell somebody tonight, you can just say, Lord, here I am.
Yes. Yeah.
Talking to a man just the other day, and he looked at me, and he looked at me with tears running down his face, and he says, I know that I made mistakes. And he said, I done things I shouldn't have done, and I'm sorry for them. Do you think the Lord would forgive me? Sister Margaret, with the greatest of hopes that I knew within my heart, I looked at him and I said, yes, the Lord will forgive you.
Yes.
I said, the Lord said, you come unto Him. And I said, He'll in no wise cast you out. So I'm telling you tonight, just come. I'm telling you, just turn your life over to the Lord. Let God be God of your life. And I'm telling you how much that He loves you and how much that He cares for you. The Bible said that in this world you'll have tribulation, but Jesus said, in me you can have peace. He said you can have life and you can have it more abundantly. I want you to know tonight, call that number. Call that number, but call on the Lord tonight. Call on heaven, and I know that He'll answer you tonight. We're so glad once again, and as we said, our pastors are with us tonight, and Sister Kathy has just been blessed, and we've been greatly blessed, and she is a great songwriter, and I don't know which one she's going to do first, but there's a song that she wrote that we've requested, just blesses our heart, and I know that it'll bless your heart too, because here to talk to you or to speak to your heart tonight. Sister Kathy, God bless you tonight.
Oh, wounded soldier, just keep on fighting. Though the battle rages, the end's in sight. Wounded soldier, just hold your head. There's keep on marching toward home. I'll keep believing,
hallelujah,
in my blessed Savior, till God commands, go get my children and bring them home.
Hallelujah.
Wounded soldier, just keep on fighting, though the battle
for everything that he's done for me. And we all go through battles. And I went through a battle when I was writing that song, and I got to a place that I said, just leave me alone for a few minutes. Did you ever want to be left alone so you can just regroup yourself? You know, sometimes you just get alone in the presence of the Lord.
Come on.
And I sat down on that piano, and I just thought, Lord, I've been wounded so many times, and I'm battle-scarred, Lord. But I thought about, I've got to keep fighting. I've got to keep pushing.
Amen.
And tonight, yes, that's what we got to do. We got to keep fighting,
yes,
and we got to keep pushing,
yes,
on towards the heavenly journey that we're,
yes,
on tonight. And the battle will be over after a while, folks.
Come
hallelujah.
On. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
I am a traveler, far from home. Soon, where the old will be made new.
will see Jesus. And I think about that as Pastor was singing that song. That verse of scripture came to my mind when it talked about that the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout and the voice of an archangel. And it talked about that the trump of God shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain, we shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. I'm thinking about that day. I long for that day. I look for that day. But I begin to think of how that day is vastly approaching. We were in Oklahoma and I back in July. And I thought that as we were ministering out there, that the Lord brought that scripture to my mind when it talked about the fields are white for the harvest. And we were coming down the road, and then in another place when we were in Texas just a few weeks ago, and we were coming down the road, and I looked over, and Sister Margaret, I saw the cotton fields and how that they were ripe for the harvest, that it was supper time, it was harvest time. And I began to think of how that the Lord is going to come back after those that have prepared themselves. And I don't care if it just started today. I'm telling you, you're one day closer to home than you've ever been. So you come to the Lord tonight and you say, God, here I am. And Lord, I know I need you. I need a Savior. And here's the great thing. When you say, Lord, I need a Savior, you know what he says? I need a child. I need a child. I need someone that just says, here I am, Lord. Here I am. Here I am, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go to the key of D.
Oh, there's a light in the window. The table spread in splendor. Someone standing by an open door. And I can't see. So river, Lord, I must be near it forever, for I've never been this home sick before. Oh, see the bright light shine, it's just about home time. I can see my Father standing at the faces are all familiar. No one told or feeble there anymore. Oh, this lonesome heart is crying. I think I'll spread my wings for flying, for I've never been this home sick before. Oh, see the bright light shine, it's just about home time. I can see my Father standing at the door. This old world's been a wilderness,
tonight there is a longing
yes,
in my heart
hallelujah.
For his appearing. And I think of the words, and there's a line in an old song, and it says, and I'll gladly leave behind all of these trials here below. And you understand tonight that when we think about what awaits us there, and as I said earlier, when John the Revelator, he talked about that the walls of jasper, and he talked about the gates of pearl, and I did, and to fathom that it said gates of pearl, and then he's talked about a street of gold, and I thought, man, that's well and good, and that's beautiful, and I love that, but you know what I love greater? My Jesus
yes,
is going to be
yes.
there.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Jesus.
The one that went to Calvary for me.
Come on, yes.
The one that the Bible said that while we were yet sinners, he died
yes. For
the ungodly.
Glory.
For the unrighteous. I begin to think of how that all you've got to do is say, Lord, would you save me?
Mm-hmm.
But here's the thing, though, it's also changing your life. And saying, God,
yes.
I don't want to go back to that old life anymore. Lord, I don't want to live that way anymore. Lord, I don't want to be like that anymore. But I can tell you this. There's something that can take place right now. And that is, you might have been born into this world, but you can have a new birth. And it goes like this. Now when I came into this world, I just can't recall. I don't remember anything
about my birth at all.
But on my knees one night in prayer, I never will forget I had a birth
I can't remember.
Oh, and one I can't forget. Oh, to this
world it makes no difference, and some might even frown,
but the
angels rejoice
when my name was written down. I'm
unworthy of his mercies.
Oh, but
still I made
my debt. I had a
birth I can't remember,
and one I can't forget. I never made the morning papers. I never made the evening news. When I took all
and I put on the new,
all my sin would cast into forgetfulness as the east is from the west. I had a
birth I can't remember.
Oh, and one I can't forget. Oh, to the
world it makes no difference, and even frown,
but the
angels rejoiced
when my name was written down. I'm
unworthy of his mercy,
but
still he paid my debt.
I had a
birth I can't remember,
cast to forgetfulness as he
remember.
Oh, and one I can't forget. Oh, to the
world it makes no difference. And some might even frown.
But the angels
rejoiced
when my name was written down. So
unworthy of his mercy, still he paid my debt.
I had a
birth I can't remember.
The same. You'll never ever want to go back when once you truly know him. I'm not saying that there won't be times that there's heartaches and troubles, but I will promise you this. There'll be one that'll stand by. There's one that says, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. When I was just a boy in days of childhood, I used to play till evening shadows come. Then winding down an old familiar pathway, I heard my mother call at set of sun.
Come home,
come home. I was kneeling, and the angel's wings were one wing in the air. She heard the call, it's supper time in heaven. Oh, but now I know she's waiting for me there. Shadows lengthening fast.
Come home, come home. It's supper time.
We're going home at last. Now in visions I see them standing yonder, and an old familiar voice I hear once more. All the banquet tables ready up in heaven. It's supper time upon that golden shore. Shadows lengthen fast.
Come home, it's supper time.
Lord for all the good songs that tells us we've got a better place to go. It's fine here when we're feeling the presence of the Lord, but it's going to be better later on. Be better when I remember to get my mic on in time, too. But I'm just new at this after 42 years, you know. How'd you expect me to remember every night?
New kid.
Yeah. Anyway, it's Ronald and Margie Johns from Lexington, Kentucky. You've been listening to tonight, and it's so good to have them back. And so I think there's a mic on everybody's. And we've got so many calls. I'm going to briefly scan over these, and so many. But you know, when you started assuring somebody that the Lord would forgive them.
Yes.
Well, here was a call had just come in right before that, and said it was a lady call from Madison County, and she said she had not lived the life she should have, and she wants God. She was asking God to forgive her, but she didn't want to talk to the she didn't want the one on the phone to pray for her. But the Lord knew what was going on there. All right, a lady from Perry County says that the lady felt the Lord in her living room, and said the singing was great. Isn't that good? Sherry Thompson from Cumberland, tell Ronald to remember her. He prayed for her a couple of years ago and prayed for three cousins. Janice from Fayette County for her husband and said the singers were great. Irene Wilson from Wolf County, the sounds great tonight, enjoying the music. Lady from Knott County, pray for her, one the preacher too. Well, it's two preachers, so they have joined together. Lisa from Knott County lost her mother, and she's grieving so much, and she needs prayer. Bill from Clark County for his family. Oscar from Williamsburg wants to see a grandson and is not being allowed to. And Becky from Pulaski County, Lorraine from Pike County, have physical needs. Peggy for Bill is in the hospital. Bill Combs, it's in the hospital. From Wayne County, pray for a daughter's health issue. Terry from Menifee. Greg from Madison, wife has his wife's car has been vandalized and they need help. And a lady from Breathitt County, and Maggie Ray from Pulaski is sending in $50 in honor of the station. And you know, that's very good because we're fixing to have a telethon coming up. And so we have to depend on that. And giving you a chance to be part of this ministry along with every soul that's saved, they have their part, and
Amen.
Also, and so we appreciate what you're doing and so forth. And there's so many others here from Letcher County, two different calls from Letcher County, and they need prayer. We all need prayer. All right, we're going to. We're going to ask Ronald to anoint these and pray over them, and then we will talk to the other guests. And so the last few minutes go so fast. That's go ahead and let your wife help you there.
Would you join with us? There, wherever you're at tonight, we're believing God to move in these matters of need. Father, we come before you tonight. And Lord, we bring every petition of life. And we bring the brokenhearted. And Lord, we bring the hurting. And Lord, we bring the lost. And we bring the sick and those that are shut in. And God, we bring them to the throne room tonight, Lord. And not only tonight, dear Lord, do we ask for the salvation of the soul, Lord, but also for the healing of the body. God, I'm asking you, Lord, tonight, Lord, that you would move in the homes and in the lives and those that are broken and those that are hurting. And God, I pray for the families tonight, dear Lord, that are just in the places, Lord, of sorrow tonight. Lord, I pray, Father, tonight, Lord, just open up the windows of heaven and, Lord, to pour into those lives tonight, Lord, that they may know, Lord, of an assurity of who you are tonight, of an almighty God. Father, we pray, Lord, upon each and every request, for we're believing in these tonight, dear Lord, that it shall be done. We speak it right now in Jesus' name.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen. 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 Amen.
All right.
God bless you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Well, let's talk to Kathy and Ray Stapleton from. Tell us about your church real quick. We've just got a couple of minutes, so tell us your location.
We're located at 308 Hill Street, Winchester, Kentucky. That's Clark County, and we are the Hill Street Pentecostal Church of God. And we would just love to have you pay us a visit if you don't have a home church. We'd like to reach out to the lost, the hurting, the homeless. Mm-hmm. We've got something to give at the church. We've got love, and the love of Jesus covers a multitude of sin. And we're just so happy tonight that we're able to come and be here. And we're just blessed tonight. Brother Roy, would you like to say something? He thinks I've said it all.
Did you say amen?
Amen.
All right.
Wednesday at 7, our services are Wednesday at 7 at Hill Street.
Yeah.
And Sunday evening at 6 o'clock.
Six o'clock.
Two services a week.
Yes.
Do you have another meeting or something coming up you want to talk about? We just got a minute.
Yes. We will be in Crab Orchard, Kentucky this coming Friday and Saturday night under the tent there with Brother David Hendrickson. And then also Sunday morning, we're going to be on Linden Avenue in Richmond with Brother Jeff Jackson and those good folks there for that great service there. And just the Lord, just God bless y'all tonight.
Okay. Well, it's so good to have hear from all these people that heard the service and they're making contact with God. Well, we appreciate everyone, and we are out of time, though, so we're going to have to hush. So from all of us, we want to say good night, and God bless you.
Thank you for being part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. We also accept Venmo and PayPal. Just scan the QR codes to donate. May God bless you.